गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ नाइन्थ ग्रेड. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द पोएम द हार्ट ऑफ द ट्री फ्रॉम योर बुक ट्रेजर ट्रॉव, अ कलेक्शन ऑफ ICSE पोएम्स एंड शॉर्ट स्टोरीज. दिस इज द पोएम द हार्ट ऑफ द ट्री रिटन बाय हेनरी कोलर बर्नर. So let's start recite the poem. What does he plant who plants a tree? He plants a friend of sun and sky. He plants the flag of tree's field. So beta, look at the first sentence. First line of the poem, the poet asks a question. And these type of the questions in the poems known as rhetorical questions. These type of devices are used by the poet to make the poem more interesting. In this type of rhetorical questions, poet first put the question, then reply by himself. So, in this poem, first he put the question that what does he plant who plants a tree? Means, जो ट्री को प्लांट कर रहा है उसने रियलिटी में क्या प्लांट किया. ही प्लांट्स अ फ्रेंड ऑफ सन एंड स्काई, देन ही रिप्लाई बाय हिमसेल्फ दैट अ पर्सन हु प्लांट्स अ फ्रेंड ऑफ सन हु प्लांट्स अ ट्री, ही रिप्लाई दैट अ पर्सन हु प्लांट्स अ ट्री ही प्लांट्स अ फ्रेंड ऑफ सन एंड sky, because a tree is a friend of atmosphere. It reduces air temperature and even purifies air by tapping dust and smoke. It ensures free gentle breeze. He plants the flag of breezes free, the shaft of beauty towering high. Its leaves flutter in the breeze as does a flag and provides cool shade to us. The grown-up tree looks like a beautiful tower as if it has made a home closer to the heaven. He plants a home to heaven anigh. Means, जो इंसान एक ट्री को प्लांट कर रहा है वो रियलिटी में एक सन और स्काई को एक फ्रेंड दे रहा है, ठंडी हवा दे रहा है, ब्यूटीफुल शाफ्ट जो इतनी ऊंची जाती है जैसे कि एक टावर हो, एंड उसे ऐसे लगता है कि इस प्लांट का जो घर है वो हेवन में होगा, जैसे कि हम लोग प्लांट के नीचे बैठ के हमें भी हेवन जैसी ही फीलिंग आती है. For song and mother croon of bird, in hushed and happy twilight heard. Mother croon of bird, एक मदर जो बच्चे को लोरी देती है वैसे ही एक बर्ड अपने बेबीज को सॉन्ग सुनाते हैं इन द ट्विलाइट, धीमी रोशनी में, जैसे इन एट द टाइम ऑफ डॉन एंड एट द टाइम ऑफ डस्क. The place where these are green trees is nothing short of heaven. He who plants a tree also ensures shelter for the birds whose sweet crooning in silent and happy twilight delights us. The treble of heaven's harmony, these things he plants who plants a tree. So, this stanza starts with the question, what does he plant who plants a tree? Then the poet gives the reply by himself, and at the last he writes down, these things he plants who plants a tree. It means that he who plants a tree also ensures shelter for birds whose sweet crooning in silent and happy twilight delighted us. By planting a tree, he ensures peace, harmony, and comfort for himself and others. मीन्स जब हम एक ट्रे लगाते हैं तब हम उस ट्रे के साथ साथ दूसरों के लिए शांति, तालमेल, आराम, इन सब चीज़ों को भी खुद खुद ही प्लांट कर देते हैं। Students, let us discuss the questions related with this passage from your assignment of 12th May 2020. I hope you read the instructions carefully. And there is a note in your assignment that arrange 3 notebooks for notes of English literature. It means, beta, there will be 3 books and you will maintain your notes according these 3 books, and 60% from these books we will cover in the 9th standard, and you will carry these books in the 10th grade, and next 40% we will cover in the 10th, and in the 10th year 100% syllabus from these books will be there. So let's discuss the question answers from the first stanza. So look here, this stanza starts from what does he plant, who plants a tree, and it's up to here only. He plants a home to have an anaya. So first question is, who is the poet asking the question in the first line of the extract? List any 2 things according to extract that man will do while planting a tree. So first, the poet poses the question to the reader. One who plants a tree plants a friend of sun and sky. He plants a flag of free breeze which provides soothing cool breeze. मतलब poet ने question किससे put की है? रीडर से पूछा गया क्वेश्चन, और दो ऐसी थिंग्स जो ट्री प्लांटर हमें प्रोवाइड करता है. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस सेंटेंस ही प्रोवाइड अस अ फ्रेंड ऑफ सन एंड स्काई, ही आल्सो प्रोवाइड अस अ फ्लैग ऑफ ब्रिजेस, अ शाफ्ट ऑफ ब्यूटी. यू कैन राइट डाउन मैनी टू इन योर आंसर. नेक्स्ट question is, give the meaning of the following lines. He plants a friend of sun and sky. He plants the flag of breeze free. The shaft of beauty towering high. He plants a home to heaven and I. So, explanation. The tree is portrayed as a friend of sun and sky. I earlier also told you why he called them, called the trees son of friend of sun and sky. Why he called the trees friend of sun and sky? Because the tree depends on the sun to carry out the process of photosynthesis. Similarly, the tree is a friend of sky because it takes in carbon dioxide from the air and releases oxygen in the air and thus purifies the air. Also, transpiration from trees is responsible for cloud formation in the sky before it rains. The tree grows like beautiful tower, and it appears that the tree has made a home closer to the heaven. Tree इतना ऊंचा चला जाता है, उसकी ऊंचाई की तरफ हमें देख के लगता है कि जैसे इसका घर कहीं स्वर्ग में ही हो. And next question is, in what way are the trees friend of sun and sky? How can a man plant the flag of trees is free? So tell me, in what way the trees are friends of sun and sky? So you know that it grows taller, it looks like a beautiful shaft, and breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen. How can a man plant the flag of trees? Free. Similarly, the tree is a friend of the sky because it takes in carbon dioxide from the air and releases oxygen in the air, thus purify the air. Also, transpiration from trees is responsible for cloud formation in the sky before it rains. The tree is a flag of free breeze. So, students, look carefully, then you will be able to judge that the explanation of these lines, he plants a friend of sun and sky. Also, the same answer we will give in the third question. So, better questions in this extract are the same. Next question, what is mean by shaft of beauty? What is compared to the shaft? Shaft of beauty means beam of beauty. Sundarta katham. The tree which grows high with its long narrow stem is compared to the shaft. जैसे किसी चीज की shaft लगी होती है उसी के साथ इसका comparison जो है वो किया गया है कि ये एक सुंदरता की shaft है, सुंदरता को ऊपर उठा रही है. Next question is, what is the impact of beginning the poem with the question? What is the figure of speech used here? So tell me, what is the impact of beginning the poem with the question? I told you earlier that this is just to create curiosity and anxiety in the readers to know more about the poem. And what is the figure of speech used here? I also told you that here they used rhetoric figure of speech, that is also known as hypophora and antipophora. So let's discuss second passage. This is also related with the first stanza from your poem. What is known as mother croon of bird? Mother croon is the soft song that mother bird is singing to her young one, that is also known as lobing, means lori. जैसे एक माँ अपने बच्चे को लोरी सुनाती है वैसे ही जो birds में जो word use किया जाता है उसको mother croon बोला जाता है. Why is the song sung in a hushed voice? It is sung in a hushed voice because it is sung during twilight when human activities are restricted and an atmosphere of calmness and serenity prevails. एक हर्स्ट वॉइस में क्यों गाया जाता है इसे? क्योंकि तब वहां पे पूरी शांति होती है. Next question is, what is twilight? Twilight is the faint light at the end of the day after the sun has gone, means dusk time. Why is it a happy twilight? It is a happy twilight because the mother croon sings to her young ones happily with soft and gentle voice. The word's high-pitched tone adds to the pleasant harmony of the nature. So next question is, what is meant by terrible heaven? What is meant by treble heaven's harmony? What role does the treble play in heaven's harmony? Treble, what is treble? Treble is a high tone in music. जब म्यूजिक थोड़ा सा हाई हो जाता है उसको ट्रेबल बोला जाता है. हारमोनी इज द वे इन विच डिफरेंट म्यूजिकल नोट्स आर प्लेड और संग टुगेदर एंड कंबाइंड टू मेक अ प्लेजेंट साउंड. द ट्रेबल प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द मदर क्रून सिंग्स इनटू द प्लेजेंट हार्मनी ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. गिव फोर फंक्शंस विच अ ट्री परफॉर्म ऑन दिस अर्थ. बेटे यू कैन राइट डाउन एनी फोर फंक्शंस विच द ट्री परफॉर्म्स ऑन द अर्थ बट ओनली रिलेटेड विद दिस स्टैंजा. ओके, So in this stanza, he uses a friend of sun and sky, flag of gray spray. It makes a home near to heaven. Trees provide us shelter. And what the else other, you can write down this by in your own words also. Thank you and have a nice day.